if you don't get tanked, would you like to
get up? I'm downstairs. I want Errol Spence Jr. 147 pounds. I'm moving up. I'm a big 135 pounder. I give two fucks about 140. It's a no name ass division. I want 140. I want Spence at 147. I'm gonna fuck him up. That googly eye ass motherfucker. Any ugly.
Hey, you gotta get through. You gotta get through Frank Martin first. You said you gotta get through Frank Martin.
I don't give a fuck about Frank Martin because, I'll tell you like this. I have no problem with Frank Martin. I actually like him as a person. Me and him are cool. We sparred. He's a great fighter. But honestly, I'm a fucking star. I'm going to go fight another fucking star.
Why you think Spence?
And I want Errol Spence. Why the fuck you going to go? No. Listen to this. Errol Spence wants to over there promote another fighter that he has signed. Fuck that shit. I go out to Big Fish. I'm moving up to 147. I'm going to get Errol Spence.
Man, this is wild. Super duper wild. This whole video shows you the problem with 2022 and the clout chasing goobers. I mean, look at all these. There was some fine, sweet Latina mama. Your little mama in the cut there. Beg friend in Raleigh, the Don with no whiskers. Back in my day, females, God forbid, dudes. Yeah, there was some fandom for winners, yeah? This dude here got knocked out after talking a whole bunch of ish and did nothing in the fight. And chicks and dudes trying to be all in the video with him. Back in my day, these kind of cats got clowned. And yeah, I'm sure there's a whole bunch of Raleigh fans who are going to tell me, oh man, why be? He got the bag and how much money do you make? And he made, I don't care how much he made. I could make 4 million for getting knocked out as well. Who can't do that? Yeah? I could go in there with my chin in the air and let Tank knock me out for 4 mil. That's nothing to be proud of. Yeah? That's nothing to take photos about. And this video ain't even about that. Unfortunately, that's where the problems only start. My man, Mr. One Punch KO, Mr. Chin in the Air, talking about googly eyes. Listen, Rolly, yeah? No word of a lie. The only thing that was googly about anyone's eyes was yours when Tank had your eyes spinning like a Las Vegas slot machine. Facts. About Errol Spence googly eyes. Your eyes was literally ringing. Your eyes was tweaking. You had them tweaker eyes going on. Yeah? Javonta give you that fire Baltimore tweaker eyes. That's what he did. And you're out here talking about, I don't want this, I don't want that, I want the big fish. You're the bum fish. Unbelievable. What world do we live in? This dude talking about, again, we all know what this is. He knows he ain't got no chance. There's no way Errol Spence is going to fight him. He ain't even got no good dubs. Fair enough, yeah? No word of a lie. If Rolly Romero had a beat Tank, there might be a serious conversation, innit? Let's be real now. If Rolly had a beat Tank, yeah, there might be a genuine conversation of some sort of step-up fight. But not only did you not beat Tank, you got your pack rolled up and smoked on Baltimore style. Yeah? No shame. Honestly, back in my day, people like this cat here, yeah, would be sitting at home somewhere in shame, reflecting on how damn bad they were. Instead, in 2022, it's praised. Oh, what? You got knocked out? It's like Tekashi 6ix9ine. Oh, what's that? You're a rat. You're a weird, creeper-ass rat. Oh, yeah, let's praise that. All the kids love to suck off weirdos these days. Super weird. The less character you have, the more goobery you are, the more people love it. Dudes and chicks. Super weird. These kind of cats used to be known as goobers. Now everyone trying to be all in the video with them. It's wild. And then the worst thing is, you got the interviewers actually saying, oh man, quiet down, let him speak. Quiet down, let him speak. People are actually desperate. And it's, I'm sorry, yeah, but it's this whole YouTube era as well. All these weird-ass middle-aged men chasing around these goobers like Rolly around for a video. That's another problem. That's why this guy here talking like he is. Because he's got a whole bunch of middle-aged men begging for a video with him. Oh, Raleigh, dude. No word of a lie, after the fight, them same middle-aged goober dudes were telling Raleigh, oh, Ellie Suckback. Oh, Raleigh, he did so well. Oh, Raleigh, he was winning. Just gassing him hard. Like I said, back in my day, he'd have been told what happened to all the stuff he was talking about. You got chinned with the first shot that landed. You said Tank ain't got no power. Why is it your eyes were spinning in your bonds? Yeah? Why is it your chin was wide in the air and you got clipped? Explain all the things you were saying before the fight that you didn't do none of them in the fight. That's what you should have been told. Not, oh, you did amazing. Honestly, Ellie Suckback was proper rimming him. Licking all the rim. That's what he was doing. No doubt. And that's why, today, a month after, his whole bonce was rattled. We've got him out here posted, no shame, talking about he wants Spence. And the sad thing is, in 2022, he might actually get it. That's how bad the world is today. Raleigh versus Spence is probably going to happen, truth be known. If I know boxing in 2022, yeah, no word of a lie, in 2022, if Spence versus Crawford falls through, you best believe Spence versus Romero will be up next. Facts. And the fact this dude made $3 million, I heard this cat here made $2-3 million from that fight. Unbelievable. But it just shows as well, he knows he ain't got no longevity in this game. He just trying to cash out right now. Okay, I got knocked out by Tank. This dude here, yeah, is essentially a female renter. Yeah, this dude here is renting out his booty hole to men. Yeah, he rented it out to the Baltimore Bum Slayer. And Tank jumped on him and pushed his dinner back in. And now he trying to rent his sweet Latina booty out to Spence. Oh, Spence, come blow my back out on a pay-per-view show and get me some more money. No shame having ass. This man here is a man whore. Facts. Yeah, he whoring his booty out right now to the highest bidder. What's that, Errol Spence? He's a big pay-per-view star. I can't wait to hear Canelo, honestly. After Spence versus Romero, it will be Canelo versus Romero. Because this dude is trying to sell his backside to whoever wants it. Anyway, on that note of Spence versus Romero, after obviously Spence heard this, he did indeed respond. Thankfully, thankfully he weren't that impressed. He said, "Some stuff don't need a response. Something is wrong with Buddy." I can't lie to you. This was pure facts. This was pure facts. Yeah, look at this goober. Goober have an ass, dude. But he's right. Honestly, there's not many times I tell you that Errol Spence is 100% true. This is one of them times. Yeah, there's something wrong with dude. No more truer words ever said. Googly have an ass. Oh, look at this dude. Yeah, Bum Slayer. Sorry, he's not the Bum Slayer, he the bum. Facts. The Baltimore Bum Slayer did what he does best. Slayed his bum. Yeah, pushed his bum's dinner back in for him. And the worst, look at this goofy ass Nick as well. Look at this Nick here, right there. This is the worst Nick. Of all the Nicks, yeah, in boxing. This Don here. With the dreads. Raleigh's trainer, yeah. No one is worse than that guy. To stay, look at him. He always in the cut with Raleigh. It's like his sugar daddy. It's weird. This cat here, I'd love to pull this Don's dreads off. Yeah? No skills. Calls himself a boxing trainer. Anyone who looks at Raleigh knows this ain't no boxing trainer. This here is a fangirl. Certified fangirl. And if you watch the full interview, you can actually hear this guy in the cut just waffling. Oh yeah, Spence, we want Spence. Backing it all up. How embarrassing. But yeah, man, I ain't trying to hear no more from Raleigh. And the fact he ain't taking this sport serious at all. He just looking for paydays right now. He looking to cash out. Whoever will give him the most coin to sell his booty hole, he'll be selling it. If this cat here, if his trainer had enough bread, he'd sell it straight to him. What's that, Mr. Trainer, with the long dreads? Yeah? Come push my dinner in for $1 million, Rolly. He'd be all over that. And there's a lot of people in this boxing industry that need to be ashamed of themselves. This Don here, with his hand out with his camera, begging for a photo with this goober. What's wrong with these guys? Grown-ass men begging for a photo with some goober. There was even one chick as well, the chick who was asking for the photo. She was with her man as well. I'm telling you now, if you see your man the YB on the roadside, yeah, or if you see me at an event and I'm with my girl, you best believe she ain't going to be asking for no photos. At one point, the woman actually says to her boyfriend, can you hold this? She must have passed him her wallet or her purse or something so she could take a photo with Rolly. Are you mad? But it shows you the state of men. Yeah, you got all these men's channels. Oh, men this, men that. Men need to worry about what your chick's doing. Yeah, it's no good making a YouTube channel about it. Make sure your chick ain't passing you her purse so she can take a photo with some next dude. Let's start there before we start making men's channels. Let's get your mean, let's fix up. Yeah? No doubt.